John Kapoor has been arrested today in Arizona. He was basically accused of helping to fuel the opioid epidemic. How is he accused of doing that? By bribing doctors to prescribe Subsys. Subsys is the drug that this company makes. It is a fentanyl-based spray designed to combat cancer sufferers' pain. But the allegations here have to do with essentially the company using different levers, including allegedly bribes, to convince it to be prescribed and given to people who didn't have cancer. Just to use it for more generalized pain indications.
And just to sort of step back, this is pretty rare. It's not every day you see billionaires being arrested.
That's right.
You know, it's sort of clear that there's this backlash coming, more regulators are very concerned about it. You might expect to see fines, something like that. But an actual arrest,
yes,
a 74-year-old billionaire is pretty
unusual. It puts it into a different league. There have been other executives from this company, executives current and former, who have been arrested. This certainly appears to be the highest ranking person. And so this does seem to signal the aggressiveness with which officials are going to be prosecuting these kinds of cases and going after what they say are the various parties that have helped fuel the opioid crisis here. The stock's already down, I should say, since we're looking at it from the stock perspective as well, right? It's down 34% even before today, and then you can see the plunge that we are seeing if you include today's action. And there are investigations into other companies as well, we should mention. The U.S. attorney in Connecticut is conducting a criminal probe of Purdue's marketing of OxyContin. That's been one of the name brands that's been associated with the opioid crisis. So Purdue, Endo, Johnson & Johnson's Janssen Pharmaceuticals have been sued by various cities and states. So there have been various legal actions. But as you say, Joe, this is the one that's really associated the most specifically with a person and a high-profile person at that. And again, it's interesting here that this is a company that relies on this drug and this drug alone for its business.
You know, you mentioned the stock had already been doing badly. I'm looking at another one, Endo Pharmaceuticals.
Right.
That was an $80 stock as recently as 2015, now below $7. So, you know, investor sentiment towards a lot of companies in this space has turned quite dramatically.
Well, specialty pharmaceuticals generally have been also rocked by the Valiant pharmaceutical situation. Yeah. There's just been an enormous amount of volatility. They've been rocked and been volatile because of talk about drug pricing and whether the administration is going to come down on that, even though there has not been action on that yet. There has been a lot of discussion on it. I should also mention as a side note that Kapoor also is involved in another company, Acorn. He's the chairman and largest shareholder of that company, which has been acquired by Fresenius, the German company, for $4.3 billion. Fresenius says this does not affect the deal. And so we had seen the shares dip a little bit today and then come back once there was that reassurance to investors.